Hi students, good morning all of you. Are you doing well? Organic chemistry bridge course. Okay. Having class works and completed previous work. Compulsory anyone have pending. So compulsory first to finish the class work. Maybe tomorrow I will start to IUBS and nomenclature. Today remaining concept today I will finish. So last class I explained primary, secondary, tertiary carbon atoms. So simply types of carbon atom. So primary carbon atom. If carbon atom attached to other one carbon atom or no carbon atom, primary carbon atom. Secondary carbon atom, if carbon atom attached to, if carbon atom attached to other two carbon atoms. Tertiary carbon atom means if carbon atom attached to other three carbon atoms. Quaternary carbon atom or neocarbon atom, the carbon atom attached to other four carbon atoms. Primary carbon contain hydrogens are known as primary hydrogens. Secondary carbon contain hydrogens are known as secondary hydrogens. Tertiary carbon containing hydrogens are known as tertiary hydrogens. Quaternary carbon does not contain hydrogens because neocarbon also. Because quaternary carbon means carbon atom attached to all our bonds but no need of hydrogen. So quaternary hydrogen, quaternary carbon does not contain hydrogens. Quaternary hydrogens won't be. So these are different types of example completed. And last another example. One more example. Suppose CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. Okay, for here I am taking another suppose. Here is the structure R another. So number of primary hydrogens. Number of primary hydrogens. Next. Number of secondary hydrogens. Number of tertiary hydrogens. Number of tertiary hydrogens. Here how many primary carbons? Here primary carbon. Here primary. Simply, here primary carbon. It is also primary carbon, primary carbon, primary carbon. How many primary carbons? So 4 primary carbons. Each primary carbon can be 3 hydrogens. So 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. 4. 4 into 3, 12. 12 hydrogens. Number of secondary hydrogens. Secondary means secondary carbon. The carbon atom attached to other 2 carbon atom. Here secondary. Here also secondary. How many? 2 is there. 2 carbon atoms. 2 plus 2, 4. Tertiary carbon atom. Carbon atom attached to other 3 carbon atoms. It is a tertiary. It is also tertiary. Here 1. So how many? So 2. These are all. So The above structure having primary hydrogens 12, secondary hydrogens 4, and tertiary hydrogens how many? 2. So these are primary, secondary, tertiary carbon atoms. Okay, write down. Next one. Homologous series. A series of organic compounds which differ by CH2 group. Is known as homologous series. A series of a series of organic compounds. A series of organic compounds which differ by CH2 group is known as homologous series. A series of organic compounds which differ by CH2 group is known as homologous series. So here adjacent members of this series which differ by CH2 in their molecular weight 14. Similarly, adjacent members of this series in their difference CH2 molecular weight 14. CH2 means molecular weight 14. Homologous series compounds can be prepared by similar methods. Simply once again, the adjacent members of this series in the difference molecular weight how much? 14. Molecular weight how much? 14. For example, I am taking homologous series of alkanes. For example, first two methane how much? CH4 formula, and ethane C2H6, and propane C3H8. Methane CH4, ethane C2H6, propane C3H8. Here, and butane C4H10. Here, first second differentiation CH2. Second and third CH2. Third and fourth CH2. Anyway, so homologous series. Adjacent members of in this series difference by CH2 group differentiation. In their molecular difference, how much? CH2. CH2 means how much? 14. In the molecular weight, how much differentiation? 14. So these are homologous series of alkanes. Right? Next two. Homologous series of alkenes. We know first alkene ethene. Next alkene is propane. Next alkene is butene. Next alkene is pentane. Once the ethene formula C2H4, C3H6. C4H8, C5H10. A difference how much? CH2. A difference how much? CH2. A difference how much? CH2. CH2 means 14 molecular weight difference. The adjacent members of this series differ by 14 in their molecular weight. Molecular weight 14 difference. So these are homologous series of alkenes. Next one is write down pentane or hexane also. C6H12. Difference CH2. Next, homologous series of alkanes. ethane, propane, butane, pentane, hexane. Ethane formula C2H2, C3H4, C4H6, C5H8, C6, CCH10. Here first one is second one differentiation CH2, second and third CH2, third and fourth CH2, fourth and fifth CH2. First second difference CH2, molecular weight how much? 14. Second and third here CH2, third and fourth CH2, fourth and fifth. So these are homologous series. A series of organic compound which differ by CH2 group is known as homologous series. The adjacent members of the series differ by CH2 or molecular weight 14. CH2 carbon 12, 2 hydrogens 2, 12 plus 2 14. Any compound adjacent members, so first and second one is difference CH2 means how much? 14. 14 difference. So these are homologous series. Tomorrow I will start IUPAC nomenclature. My dear students, tomorrow I will start IUPAC nomenclature. What do you mean by functional group? What do you mean by functional group? A group of atoms in a molecule to exhibit characteristic property is known as functional group. A group of atoms in a molecule to exhibit characteristic property is known as functional group. Functional definition: a group of atoms in a molecule to exhibit characteristic property, it is known as functional group. A group of atoms in a molecule to exhibit characteristic properties. It is known as a functional group. Functional group. Different types of functional group is there. Now I will give functional list. Don't confuse it. Don't forget. So remembering all formulas and all concepts. Okay. Next I will give functional group. Functional group and a formula. Okay, first two alcohols. First two alcohol means OH. Aldehydes. CHO. Ketones. CO. Carboxylic acids, COOH. Carboxylic acid, COOH. After that, sulfonic acid, SO3H. Next, amines. NH2. Amides NH2. Amides. CONH2. Their formula. Acid halides COX. Acid halides COX. Esters COOR. And acid anhydrides. Acid anhydrides. COOOC. Acid anhydrides. So these are main functionals. Aldehydes. And another one is ethers. Ethers. So alcohols, aldehydes, ketones, esters, carboxylic acids, sulfonic acids, amides, amines. And acid halides, esters, acid anhydrides, ethers. So these are all different types of functional groups. Don't forget these functional groups. Remembering all formulas. So these are all functional groups. Here bond means alkyl group is there. After that I will explain. Here bond means your bond is there. Your bond before R. R means alkyl group. Now I will explain. Suppose carboxylic acid is there. Carboxylic acid formula here. How can write this structural formula? How can write this structural formula like that? COOH or COOH. How can write the structural formula of carboxylic acid? And next, aldehydes. How can write the structural formula of aldehyde? Alde simply we are writing like that. Simply COH aldehydes. Next, ketones. How can write the structural formula? These are ketones simply like that. Actually, CO like that bond. Here are ketones. Next one is esters. Ester means COOR. How can write the structural formula? COOR or COO bond R. Esters. And amides. Amides formula CONH2. How can write the structural formula? Simply CONH2. Amides. Amides. And acid halides. Acid halide means simply COX. Simply COX like that. X means halogen. Chlorine means acid chloride. Iodine means acid iodides. And acid anhydrides. Acid anhydrides. Acid anhydride means actually COOOC given actually. How can I write the structure means? CO. O CuO like that. Then acid anhydride structure. Acid anhydrides. Now I am giving functional group formula under structural formula. Under structural formula. Next one is sulfonic acid. Simple structure SO3H. How can I write the structural formula? SO3H means like that. OH. SO3H. Sulfonic acid structure. How can I write the structural formula of functional groups? Functional groups. Okay? So these are all different types of functional groups. What is meant by alkyl group? What is meant by alkyl group? Alkyl group is denoted by symbol R. The removal of one nitrogen atom from alkanes is known as alkyl group. The removal of one nitrogen atom from alkanes is known as alkyl group. For example, now I am taking alkanes. So these are alkanes. Removal of one nitrogen atom. That means so R, alkyl. Okay, alkyl group is represented by symbol R. Example, R equal to CH3. That group is known, these are alkyl. That is known as methyl. And next row, C2H5. That is known as ethyl. Ethyl also represented like that. CH2, CH3 bond. And another. C3H7, propyl. Propyl. Propyl means like that. CH2, CH2, CH3. Propyl. Okay, next another one is C4H9, butyl, like that, CH2, CH2, CH3, sorry, CH2, CH2, CH3, butyl. So these are our different types of alkyl groups. Alkyl groups means the removal of hydrogen atom from alkanes is known as alkyl group. Methyl, ethyl, propyl, butyl. Okay, so methyl means CH3, ethyl means CH5, propyl means C3H7, butyl means C4H9. So these are all different types of alkyl groups. So methyl, ethyl, propyl and butyl, etc. Anyway, the removal of a nitrogen atom from alkanes is known as alkyl group. Okay, alkyl. Suppose I want ethyl chloride. Ethyl chloride's formula. So ethyl chloride formula means ethyl means C2H5Cl. Cl. Ethyl chloride. Simply. And propyl alcohol. Propyl alcohol. How can it say? Propyl means formula C3H7. And keep OH simply propyl alcohol. Propyl alcohol. So like that simply. Ethyl chloride, propyl alcohol like that. So these are alkyl groups. What do you mean by alkyl? Removal of a nitrogen atom from alkanes are known as alkyl group. It is denoted symbol R. R means alkyl group. Suppose I am taking R and OH is there. That compounds are called alcohols. R bond. Suppose R CHO is there. That compounds are called aldehydes. Suppose R CO R is there. That compounds are called ketones. I'm writing another. Before I kept bond, instead of bond, bond is attached to alkyl group. Alkyl group is nothing but carbon composite. Suppose RCOOH is there, carboxylic acids. Carboxylic acids. R bond NH2, that compounds are called amines. Okay, so these are alcohols, aldehydes, ketones, carboxylic acid, amines. These are functional group with alkyl group. Functional group with alkyl group. Okay, next. Types of alkyl groups. Types of alkyl groups. Alkyl group generally, first one is N alkyl groups. Isoalkyl groups. Types of alkyl groups, N alkyl groups, isoalkyl groups. And third one is neoalkyl groups. Types of alkyl groups. So N alkyl, isoalkyl, neoalkyl groups. N alkyl, isoalkyl, neoalkyl groups. Actually, these are obtained from alkenes. N-alkane, isoalkane, neoalkane. These are obtained from. N-alkane is obtained from. N-alkanes. These are obtained from. Isoalkanes. They are obtained from. Neoalkanes. N alkyls, isoalkyls, neoalkyl groups. N alkyls are obtained from N alkane. Generally, alkanes classified into N alkanes, isoalkanes, neoalkanes. So, N alkane means normal, straight chain. Iso and neo means branched. So, N alkane means straight chain. Iso and neo means branched. Isoneo means branched. Now we will say alkyl group before N-alkanes. N-alkane means normal. Normal. That means straight chain. And isoalkane means branched. Branched chain, isoalkanes. Okay, neoalkane means iso means branched chain. That means second carbon having one methyl group. Second carbon ion on methyl group, that is known as isoalkanes, branched say. Neoalkanes, two branches, that means second carbon ion second carbon having two methyl groups. In the chain, second carbon having one methyl group, that is known as iso. In the chain, straight chain, second carbon having two methyl group, that is known as neo. Second carbon having two methyl group is there, that is neo. Neo alkane means two branches. So N alkanes, removal of nitrogen atom from N alkanes, that is N alkyne. Removal of nitrogen atom from isoalkane, that is known as isoalkane groups. Removal of nitrogen atom from neoalkane, that is known as neoalkyne. So N alkanes, normal straight chain. Isoalkanes, branched chain, second carbon having one methyl group. Neoalkane, two branches and second carbon having two methyl groups. Okay, so these are example. Write down N alkanes, normal straight chain. Isoalkanes, branched chain, second carbon having one methyl group. Neoalkane, two branches. So carbon having, so second carbon having two methyl groups. So N alkylu, isoalkylu, neoalkylu. N alkyl obtained from generally N alkanes. Isoalkyls are obtained from isoalkanes. So neoalkyl obtained from neoalkanes. N alkane means straight chain. Isoalkane means second carbon having. In N alkane, second carbon having on methyl group, that is known as isoalkanes. Isoalkyl, okay. And neoalkyl. In neoalkanes, second carbon having two methyl group, that is known as neoalkyl, or two branches. So neoalkanes. So N alkanes, isoalkanes, neoalkanes. Second carbon having. Here, N alkanes, example, CH3, CH2, 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 N-butane, and isoalkane, example, isobutane. And neoalkane example, neopentane. N alkanes straight chain. N-butane, straight line carbon atoms is there, no branches. Isoalkanes, second carbon atom, one methyl group. So in N alkane, second carbon contain methyl group. Yeah, actually straight chain is there. In straight chain, second carbon having one methyl group, that is known as isoalkane. Neoalkane. So in straight chain, second carbon means two methyl groups. Second carbon contain two methyl groups, that is known as neoalkane. Neoalkane contain compulsory middle neocarbon. Neocarbon means quaternary carbon. So these are N alkanes, isoalkane and neoalkane. Okay, my dear students, today enough. Once see. Okay, students, today enough. Thank you for remaining. Tomorrow I will explain. Okay, thank you for all.